Parental advisory warning. This is my channel. Oh, okay, I was just making sure you knew.
I just think it's crazy how I got a pillow for my doctor every time I come here. This is crazy. And then they need to put a wig stand in here too, because you got my shit folded up, laid up on the, look, on the lap.
The sweat from your drink gonna make her curly. Goddamn.
Timmy's out. He ain't even take me out for dinner yet, bitch.
So this is my first in-person appointment with the famous Dr. Castiglione. Hey, doctor. Prior to this one, we had telehealth visits, which were done on Zoom because of COVID, but they were very brief. So at this appointment, we were going to get deep tissue in.
So hold this for a second. So I need to see the x-rays, but generally speaking, now, do you wear wigs or anything or no?
Maybe, sometimes.
Because, you know, usually when you're, what we do is we kind of contour this down a little bit. You got to tell me if this is what you want or not. But usually we contour this and smooth this out a little bit. The CAT scan tells us how the best way to do that is, but, you know, the basic get rid of the little bump, and what most people want is this to be a little less full.
Right.
To get that, though, you need an incision over the top. So there's a scar here, and your hairline is also, you know, already high. So you certainly don't want to pull that, you know, back higher. Interested in it or not, hard to pull this forward, so you're probably better off wearing a wig. I don't know if you that much. Do you?
Why would that be the better off thing to do?
Well, the other thing is that you put a scar back here further, but it's still a scar. Your hairline is high, so sometimes people want to wear a wig to cover that over. That's all I'm saying.
Wigs are a lot of money.
What's that?
Wigs are thousands of dollars.
Well, some of them are.
All of the ones I want to wear are.
But we basically grind down the bones here and in here a little bit, but that's why I need to see the CAT scan to see if it's safe. And we had talked about your nose maybe taking the bump down a little bit and narrowing this. Mm-hmm. Your tip's pretty good. The question is whether or not these need to be brought in a little bit. Now, when I look at your upper lip, when you look at this, some people are doing a lip lift where they pull this up,
mm-hmm.
but your distance from here to here is already not that long. It's a nice shaped lip, you know what I mean? And if you were to do this, I think it would make you look too weird. So I think it's best not to do the lip, but
wow,
to do...
I want my lip. Well, can we add, maybe?
Well, the add, you have to do some sort of injection.
I just feel like my lip is going to be small.
You think so?
I know so. It is already. Like, I feel like it's not... Well...
So what I'm saying, though, is when you do a lip lift, what you're doing is you're pulling this up. And you see how it shows you, makes your teeth show more?
Yeah.
A lot of people don't like that, but when you look at the distance from here to here, it's not long. Some people have very long upper lip.
So yeah, but I'm talking about here on these sides. Not a lift, but I know you can do fillers.
To fill it in there. Fillers, however, don't last forever.
That's going to last enough for my mental stability.
So you'll have a splint on your nose. The worst thing is it'll get bruised in black and blue, which it does from here and from here. And that takes about 3 weeks, sometimes 4 weeks to go away.
Yeah.
Maybe you sleep with your back elevated, put ice on as much as possible. Walk around, but you really want to keep your head elevated. And generally, swelling and bruising goes away. Okay. But there is a little splint on here. The bones are a little narrower. This is a little narrower. And then they take out a little bit here so that this is a little bit narrower, not too much. I don't like scars that go up here like Michael Jackson had. I take out on the inner side.
God, you know what he had?
Well, you can see it. He had it like 23 times.
I couldn't. I'm regular. You're not regular. Yeah. You're a superhero.
But here's the question still. We've got to decide where... to
my
make an incision
up here.
So, you know, we can make an incision. Do you always
can we do the thighs?
To get to here, you got to do it all the way across.
Oh.
It means you're going to end up with some numbness here. So, but generally speaking, I can make it back a little bit. We sometimes try to do it right at the hairline and see if we can advance this down a little bit. In other words, make the incision here and try to bring your hair forward a little bit. It doesn't
like a hair transplant?
No, but just kind of undermine here and bring this forward and remove skin here so that the hairline comes down to about this level.
Okay.
Are you shaving in here or cutting, or is this just thinned out here?
Don't play with me, sir.
No, seriously.
That's where my hair.
I have no hair, so I can't. I don't know anything about this stuff.
Okay, first of all, don't do me.
So, then I think the best incision is here and then back into here. And I would try to move this down forward a little
bit. My skin definitely has enough elasticity to do that, right?
Or do you think it only moves a little bit. It doesn't move a ton. Okay. And then sand these down. And then this, I just want to see how much I can sand this down safely without getting into the sinus. That's all.
So wait, do you have to move the hairline?
I don't have to. I can leave it right where it is.
But this and this can still get done.
Yeah, wherever I make the incision, yeah.
Okay, so why don't you just do that? Because I don't really care about you moving the hair. Right.
So then we'll make, so I have to shave a little strip that will grow back, and it will make the incision back here, okay? Does that make sense?
Because the hairline moving forward seems like a stress on my body.
So that's fine. And you're going to do the breast area too?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to stand up for a second. Now one side is bigger than the other, so we want to do silicone, right?
Yeah.
12 centimeters wide, so you usually make a little incision under here and then put the implant in. At first it looks kind of weird, like really high and stuff, but
least side boob as possible.
Yeah, so we want something very narrow so it doesn't stick out too much, because I have to center the implant on the nipple, you know what I mean? You can't like put the implant here and then the nipple point outward, so it just, and you're slim, so it just means we don't go too big. But what, did you bring a bra with you today or no?
No, actually.
Well, because we need you to try on implants to decide how big you want to be.
I've already done this and I've already came to that conclusion.
For all the viewers in the back that's wondering, it was my birthday prior to this appointment and I had braids, like single braids and cornrows in the front and stuff. So I just took my hair out of braids and I had to get the scalp checked at and all that stuff. So bitch, don't fucking do me. It's very India Irie. I am not my hair about the situation. Not too much.
I don't want to be the small titty fat girl. Cause I'm already the small titty skinny girl. So I'm getting surgery to be small titty fat girl.
Hi. Dr. Stigman said you didn't bring a bra, right?
No, I literally just wanted to see the 375.
Alright, so
the
these are the 375s.
And what is this in the back?
The saline or something?
I guess. I don't see it.
See what?
For me, I want it bigger. Yeah, this is more like it. Ah, this is them. This is them. Here they come. Me and my, let me see in the mirror. Me and my glory.
I can't.
And this goes underneath this, right? Mm-hmm. So this will be on top of this implant.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's gonna give orangutan for a couple of.
It'll be high and low. It'll be a high, and then things will settle down into position.
I like how that sounds.
Because I look like torpedoes. They settle down.
After how many months? Maybe a year?
Not a year.
Less than that. I'm gonna be in hibernation. If my surgery is still as planned, August 30th, I'm not coming outside until like February.
First of all, in February you'll be out the house by then.
No, I'm not. Y'all could if y'all want to.
But what are you hibernating for?
Because I don't want to come out with no high-profile torpedo.
But so they're going to be putting in the first 3 months, yeah. If that.
But
I'm still going to wait. Y'all fine. I'm still going to wait.
You'll see it's when you be coming into the business. You'll see the change, and it's not as bad as you're making it seem.
This is my personal driver for the next few, well, forever. Well, actually, but for the next few days, that's his personal job. That's it, taking off just for me. How does it feel? How do you, as my best friend, feel at this very moment in time?
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm very excited, but I'm not that excited. You know why? You said I can't play with them, so.
Oh my God!
The infamous before. Naturalist fuck. Let's just take a look at the size of those knickers right there. Catch the bounce. Catch the shimmy. Catch the projection, darling. Or the lack thereof.
Wow, looks like he's packing for a camping trip. I hope you have snacks in there.
Oh.
Huh?
I'm sorry, it doesn't ever
surgery time is 5.5 hours, and it begins at 7:15.
Back up.
They're shady.
Back up.
They're shady because I'm black, and they told me to come at 5. Y'all thought I was gonna be late, cause I was. Okay, I see someone in blue. We're talking business, Dola. You okay over there?
To keep you warm, and a pair of feet, okay? And this is just clean mask in here now.
You do a lot of footwork when you can't get the feet in here.
Yeah, you can just put that in here, and then
we're gonna leave the feet here. Nike, call me. Hey, you boy. Are they gonna come and draw my titties?
Mm-hmm.
Come and draw my titties. You gonna be like, let me see. I'm gonna be like. Ladies, I will say this. Go with your gut, but don't overdo it. The doctor said I should get 370, and I called a few days in advance after having slept on it and said I wanted 390 moderate high instead of the 370 high profile. And I'm actually happy with my results, so, you know.
Honestly, they all look kind of similar. They're not that scientific.
It's not that much of a big difference.
On a pain scale, really show 0 to 10, 0 really, to 10. On a pain scale, 0 to 10,
doesn't really
ten,
make much difference.
I just kind of want that much for
that
thing. I've only ever seen this on botch. We just don't want to, go too wide. That's all.
I mean, I still don't.
This won't be my first time doing anesthesia, though, so I know the risks.
If you're cold, you can put the robe on. If you're not, then don't bother with it.
Yes, I am.
You need to buggy.
here's where the excitement kicked in. Adrenaline, I was happy, I was ecstatic. It was such a feeling, but when I tell y'all I was ready, baby, I was ready. Get into it.
Hey, Lala. It's me, Lala. I got a sweet, you guys, from my recovery.
And you don't see no, what you call it, right? You don't see no...
Can you sit up? I'm just saying, like, can you, you know?
Yeah, I'm totally fine. Not totally.
Where is the most pain? If you can
my
feel it.
My fucking dry ass throat.
It was at this point where I realized I should have just fucking laid down when I came in. Fuck these cameras, because I was getting annoyed by the questions. Like, leave me alone.
Are we on water?
Here. Mm-hmm. My nose doesn't feel painful as much as it feels, like, uncomfortable.
Tension, maybe.
Here, lots of pain. I feel like I can feel the incision, like the pain in that area. I can feel my muscles doing, like the inside of my body is doing whatever it does to heal itself, and I can feel it. I keep crying.
Because what?
Not sad, but like tears just keep coming out of my eye. My lips are numb.
Could you?
Like, this was a lot. Like, I literally just had my brain banged on. And my nose beat up. Bitch, back up.
I can do it.
We are back at the hospital. Was feeling some heat, some hotness in her head, and she threw up. The throw up startled her. It came out her nose. Very nauseous. She's feeling. She did lay that she was laying down, but she just was laid out for too long, so she has to be mobile as well. So during her mobile time, she had a big throw up that startled her, came out her nose and everything else. So we're back at the hospital to make sure everything's good. No, she didn't. This bitch was just strung out a minute ago.
I can't believe this shit. Just say no. No, I'm just playing.
This is just a brief video to explain the pain I'm going through. So my doctor gave me an Oxycontin or codeine, whatever, Oxy. Upon the end of the surgery procedure. And I was told to take another one at 7 p.m. It is definitely not 7 p.m. It's like, I don't know what time it is. It's past 7. But I'm making this video because the pain that they say about the breast, like there's someone sitting on your chest. Nah, y'all sugarcoating it. Let's be real. It feels like not only is someone sitting on my chest and it's heavy, but, excuse me, I gotta breathe. But I feel like it feels like I'm being pulled apart and it hurts. My head is killing me. I have an excruciating headache.
Watch. She passing out. Catch it. This is a fucking key so bad to me.
Oh, shit. I almost fell asleep. Bye, y'all.
Hey, you guys. So, fortunately enough, the hospital has a fab recovery room. I'm outside right now on the balcony. But it has a fab room with a pull-out couch for company. And you know, any necessities that I need can be accommodated for me upon request. I will say that it is, I don't know what time it is. It's late at night though.
Late? Oh girl, I was tired.
Probably like 8 going on 9 o'clock, maybe 8 going on 8:30. And right now I took my first painkiller since being from the hospital. Earlier I took an antibiotic and I like threw up literally right after, and I think it's because I didn't eat any food. But at this moment, I don't feel terrible. And I really am appreciating this. They prescribed me 5 milligram oxycodone or some shit. I'm allergic to acetaminophen, which is in like other painkillers. But anyway, God is good. Here we are. Day one after surgery. I have to take my time when I talk because I feel like I'm out of breath. My face is definitely swollen now. Yesterday definitely wasn't as swollen. And I was supposed to sleep with an ice pack all night, but bitch, that shit hurt it too. Oh, shit. So, as you can see, my lips still swollen. My eyes are getting very swollen. I have an ice pack for my eyes that I'm going to put on once it gets cold. I got no sleep last night. Like, none. Okay? I'm allowed to take oxycodone every 7 hours. And bitch, I've been taking it every 7 hours. Last night on my way to bed though, I was afraid to take anything because I didn't want to throw up. I don't feel like I ate enough. My appetite is low. Cause bitch, I'm a big girl and I like to eat. But it's just too much. It's too much pressure. But yeah, that's update number one. I really like my forehead. I can say that. I like it a lot. And I like my nose a lot. The glass is sending me. I'm not going to leave you out. You're off. All right. Oh, shit. It burned it. Oh, yeah. The chest burns a lot. And I try to move around a lot, though. Because you don't want to get any blood clots. So, just circulate the body. Don't do too much bending. Open this fucking blind up, bitch. Ugh. Ugh. Yeah. Okay, so it's night number 2. I wouldn't say I've gotten, like, sleep, but I've definitely gotten rest. My chest is burning. Like, literally burning. I feel like I can feel it healing itself. And I have a great immune system, so I know it's working. And I love my body for being happy and all that good shit, but come on now. The swelling on this face. My eyes. Gotta clean them out. That's pretty much that. Now look at this shit. He gets to eat chicken and french fries. Well, I was eating fucking mashed potatoes and some nasty ass clam chowder. I thought it was gonna be good and it came out thick. It's like gravy, bitch. Ooh.
Maybe you could chew on a fry.
I do like french fries. My throat. Let's talk about that. They put a breathing tube in your throat, you know, so you can breathe during surgery. Them bitches was rough because I could just feel my throat. Like, everything just felt wrong down there. My esophagus felt, like, cut up. or it just feels not like itself. But anyway, I'm only walking around again to keep circulation going, to keep the blood flowing. A few hours away from post-op appointment, where they take off the...
Just playing a little hide and seek.
It's not the time.
Okay, sorry.
Where they're gonna take the bandages up top for my breasts off. Let's go take a little walk. But that's okay, because I look cunt. Okay? The nose is cunt, darling. The nose is cunt, darling. As you can see, I have a little swelling in my lip from the Juvaderm. I'm hoping that my Juvaderm doesn't my Juvaderm doesn't migrate anywhere and get all nasty on me. But so far, I'm very happy with the work. I really wish I had an on-call doctor every second just staying with me, because I don't know why the fuck people don't want to go to medical school no more and be friends with nobody.
You think about it with the medical school would have been to fucking take care of you after your plastic surgery? That's what you think my fucking medical degree would have been for?
That's why you're blurred out in the back, honey.
I don't care.
Then I have this ugly, sinister laugh. I don't like it. But anyway, I'm gonna lay down until my appointment. What time is it?
Not even 10 yet.
It's 9:40 in the morning. I don't even wake up this early. Ever. I don't ever wake up this early. Bitch, I'm not no 9 in the morning type of bitch. Unless I'm getting a coin. Because this is not right. I need to be in bed sleeping. I just can't even sleep, you guys. It's like I have to take drugs to go to sleep. So, yeah. Whew. I'm going to go sit down for a minute. Drink this hot tea. See if it could make my throat feel a little better. I got mint. I'll talk to y'all at my appointment. I don't look too bad, and I'm happy about it. I'm up and at 'em. I ain't got no clothes on, but. I wasn't giving that. Oh, how dare you. Yeah, thank you.
I don't like other people's pain, so I'm very gentle. There you go.